good evening, morning, whatever it is for you all. I am back. Haven't been on for a little while, but I thought I'd go ahead and do a little bit of a streaming today. Actually planning on doing a little bit of film quests tonight. I'm planning on actually doing the Gunner's Ground. This quest is a free-to-play quest. According to the read-up on the RuneScape wiki, it states that this replaces the Romeo and Juliet quest. And so it's basically the premise is a smitten dwarf sits alone, forlorn, his love full formed but lost. Will you help to guide his path and uncross a love star crossed? It is a free-to-play quest. It is novice difficulty. I'm trying to get all those out of the way. Its official length is short to medium. Skill requirements is a net level 5 crafting. And we gotta go to, and apparently there's an enemy to defeat that's optional. Is Hacken the Champion. I will deal with that later. But I gotta go to the Dwarf Village. The Barbarian Village. So I'm gonna go ahead and okay, there we go. It's over here off of Edgeville. And if you are joining, please feel free to pop in and say hello. Yeah, it would be really appreciated if you could. But anyways, as I was saying, I'm going to be going to the Barbarian Village, and I will be speaking with Dororin. He's a dwarf sitting alone beside the wooden fence east of the Barbarian Village. He's near the fishing spot and the bridge. I thought I had started this one before, but I guess I hadn't. Let's just double check. Once this thing comes up, let's just double check the map, just make sure I'm in the right area. Provided the blue arrow shows up, because every so often I've noticed it doesn't show up, like right now. I am going to go on down that way. There's our blue arrow. But anyways, don't know why I've got such a that's the gentleman that we need to speak with. He sates at my heart with burdens heavy does it lie, for never did I never did I ever give the evil eye. What the heck? He says you're a poet too? I'll say yes, what the heck. I'm sure you can identify with the arduous state of my life. My heart is stricken with that most audacious of maladies. I'm just gonna pick one. Angina, hypertension, or I'm just gonna go with hypertension. Love, he says. The walls of my heart are besieged by love's armies, and those walls begin to tumble. In the barbarian village lives a fairest maiden I have witnessed in all my life. And I'm going to ask what's so special about her. I wouldn't know where to start. Her fiery spirit, her proud bearing, her winsome form. But why is this making you so sad? Is my question. The people of this village value strength, stature, and riches. I have none of these things. My people are indomitable warriors, dripping with gold and precious gems, but not I. I am not built for combat, and poetry has proven a life of poverty. There must be something you can do is my thing. If Gudrun could ever love a dwarf, surely she would need to see my artistry. Will you help me? I am no crafter of metal. Sure, let's see. Required items, none. Good. I will accept the quest. I need a ring of purest gold, then we can drape it with words of my heart. Oh, I know, the perfect place to get a gold ring. Edgeville's metalsmith Jeffrey labors like myself under the weight of unrequited love. Perhaps if you took one of my love poems to Jeffrey, he would trade it for a gold ring. And he gives me a poem. I'm going to ask him a couple questions. By all means. Does it have to be a ring from Jeffrey? Yes, Jeffrey's rings are timeless works of incomparable romantic splendor. I want to ask about something else. Why can't you go yourself? Some time ago, Jeffrey asked me for advice in acting on his affections. I gave him the best advice that I could. Things didn't work out very well for him. One thing led to another. Now he no longer wishes to speak to me. I'm going to ask him one other thing. Why can't you give a poem directly to Gudrun? These love poems are written in the Mistelinian style. A noble barbarian maiden would be insulted, not flattered. Okay, let's ask another question. You want me to trick her into making you thinking you made the ring? Oh no, nothing like that. I have the words, I just need your help with the tools. Let's see if there's anything else I need to ask. That's relevant. Okay, so I gotta go all the way back up to Edgeville. Okay, so I basically gotta go near the furnace up there. Jeffrey. Jeffrey, Jeffrey, Jeffrey. Stop moving around. Talk to Jeffrey. Keep it quick. What do you want? I'm here about a gold ring. You want to buy a gold ring? You want to sell a gold ring? You want to ask pointless questions about gold rings? I was hoping you would trade me a gold ring. Trade you? Trade you for what? This splendid love poem. A love poem? What? Wait, that dwarf put you up to this, didn't he? Yes, he did. Let's see what he says. That cheeky little... He just can't leave it alone, can he? Fine, I'll trade you for the poem. What is it you want? Just a plain gold ring. Now leave me in peace. So I've got the gold ring. Engraved ring from... I'm going to examine the ring. Gold ring by Jeffrey of Edgeville. It doesn't look particularly special to you. And I get to bring him back to Doran. So down south we go again. So we are on our way south to speak with the dwarf again. I await in eagerness for a loop of lustrous grandeur. No, that just sounds ridiculous. Have you brought me a ring from Jeffrey? I have one right here. I show Doran the ring from Jeffrey. Thank you, that's exactly what I need. Now, would you engrave something on it for me? What do you want me to engrave? I've given this some thought. Gudrun the Fair, Gudrun the Fiery. How do I engrave that? No, never mind. Sounds simple enough. Just use the chisel on the gold ring. Okay. Isn't a chisel a bit clumsy for that? I have seen you crafters use them for all sorts of precise work. Okay, I've got a chisel, I think. You engrave Gudrun the Fair, Gudrun the Fiery onto the ring. Yay. Now I'm gonna... Is it done? Have you created a work of magnificent beauty? How does this look? Show Doran the engraved ring. Grant, that's perfect. Will you do one more thing for me? Of course. I fear she will only judge this poor book by its cover. Would you take the ring to Gudrun for me? Okay, I'll go ahead and do it. Please don't tell Armored Dwarf just yet. Where is she? Inside the barbarian village. She's inside the barbarian village. According to this, she's southwest of the mine, so that means we gotta go over here. There she is. Talk to Gudrun. You caught enough? Yes, I have plenty of fish. Your father needs many fish to feed the freemen. Shell, I know, Gudrun says. Shell says, maybe you sneak off to the Outlander city again by fishing market instead of catching them? Shut up, I'm much better at fishing than you. You are not, says Shell. Just guard the hut like the chieftain told you to. Fine. Stupid barbarian, she says. Sorry about that, stranger. Did you want something? Are you Gudrun? Yes, she says. This is for you. Show her the ring. It's lovely, there's something written on it. Gudrun the Fair, Gudrun the Fiery, is it about me? Yes. This is a beautiful gift, stranger, thank you. And how do I do this? You speak to her and give her the ring, she will think you were giving it to her, so tell her that someone else sent you. Oh, who is it from, she says. Tell her it's from a secret admirer? Does that really happen? How exciting, she says. This man, he's from outside the village? Yes. I would love to leave the village and be romanced by exotic, handsome Outlander men. There is a problem, though. What's that? My papa, the chieftain, he would never let an Outlander pursue me. Why not? He thinks all your people are our enemies. So you want me to talk to your father? I suppose that might work. I've tried to reason with him, but he's impossible. Maybe he'll listen to you. I know some of the others feel the same, but they're loyal to Papa. Where is he? In the longhouse at the north end of the village, drinking and shouting. Okay, so we go to the longhouse. Look for Chief Gunther in the Lord's Hall and talk to him. Talk to Chieftain. Be gone, Outlander. You are not welcome here. I need to speak with you. Make it short. Your daughter seeks permission to court an Outlander.
What?
Your daughter seeks permission to court an Outlander. You have any idea who we are? You're barbarians. We are the storm that sweeps from the mountains. We are the scourge of these soft lands. Please wait a moment. We are the Freemen of the Ice. You think this is a settlement, but it is a camp of war. Chieftain, may I interrupt, says Hakan. What is it, Hakan? We have lived here since before the time of my father. Perhaps we are no longer a camp. Your father? Do you honor him, Hakan?
Of course.
And do you honor Warlord Gunner?
Of course, Chieftain.
Then why do you dishonor his name by abandoning what he fought for? We will honor our fathers and we will honor Gunner. Yes, Chieftain, you are wise. I am sorry. You, Outlander.
What?
We are not friends, you and I. We are not allies. Run back to Gunner and tell her to remember her forefathers. Tell her to think of Gunner and what he would think of this insult. Now go before I have Hakan dismember you.
I'm going. Go back to Gundred.
We shall go back to Gundred and see what she has to say. Speak to Gundred. What did he say? He mentioned someone called Gunnar and that you should think about his feelings.
By the eyeballs of Guthrix, always Gunner.
Who's Gunner?
He was my great-grandpa. He founded this village 100 years ago.
You don't seem to share your father's attitudes toward him.
I think there's a difference between respecting my ancestors and obsessing over them. Papa thinks whatever stupid war Gunner fought is still going on.
I don't know. Maybe your mystery man has some ideas.
I'll ask him.
So I go back to Dwarf Boy. And we shall ask him what he has. Did you give Gunrun the ring? What did she think? Did it capture her heart?
There's a problem. It's because I'm a dwarf, isn't it? Or because I'm a poet. I knew it. I'm completely worthless.
No, she liked the ring.
Oh, then, what's the problem?
Most cruel is fate, most cruel, why not?
He's obsessed with the stories of his ancestors. He says his people are still at war.
This village has stood for 100 years.
I heard him arguing with one of the others. He says he honors his ancestors this way.
Really? Interesting. Do you know a lot about the village history?
Not really. I talked with Hundrig, who guards this tower here.
An idea occurs to me, but it's hubris of the greatest magnitude.
What is it?
What if I wrote a poem, forged a sweeping historical epic, crafted a tale to touch the chieftain's soul?
Will that work?
To win the heart of my beloved from her father's iron grasp, it's worth a try. It's worth it just to try.
So the dude scribbles it.
Even the bloodiest rose must settle. Mixed metaphor of what settles. Detritus, that's hardly flattering. Even the rolliest boulder. How's the poem going?
I'm stuck. I'm a worthless wordsmith. My work is pointless. My life is pointless.
I'm sure that's not true.
I'm stuck on a word. By the Colossus of King Olivus, I can't find the words.
Well, maybe I can help. What sort of word?
I don't know. I'm not sure. Some kind of word. Scientists, I just feel it would go.
Maybe you could suggest some words to get me started, then I could tell you more.
Alright, how about, let's start with barbarian. It doesn't really fit. It needs to be one syllable long. Grass. That really doesn't fit. It needs to rhyme with the word day. Okay. May. That doesn't really fit. It needs to mean something like wandering aimlessly. Rome. That doesn't really fit. It needs to rhyme with the word day. Stray. And from his righteous purpose, never stray. That fits. It's perfectly right, meaning right thanks, right rhyme, well done. The poem still isn't finished, though. I have another missing word. Give me another one. Anything to get me started. Grass. It doesn't really fit. It needs to rhyme with word yet. Sweat. That doesn't really fit. It has to mean something like danger. Threat. It's long, but long is gone the author of that threat. Perfect. Yes. It's coming together. We're nearly done. One more to go. This one is tricky, though. It's a phrase I need. Someone did something. Drew the balls, ate a tasty pie, schemed intently, went for a walk. It needs to be three syllables long. Made a raft? That doesn't really fit. Needs to rhyme with the word lore. Let's go with swept to war. Who then in face of madness swept to war? That's it. That's brilliant. At last it's done. It's finished. My finest work. Thank you so much for your help. Are you ready to present it to the chieftain? What? No, I'm a writer, not a performer. I think the chieftain would respond best to one of his people. Perhaps you could ask Gudrun to recite it to her father. He gives me the poem. Now I'll get right on it. So we go back to Gudrun. To Gudrun. What have you gotten there? Another gift from your mysterious suitor. A scroll? It's a poem, a story to convince your father to settle down. You could recite it to him. Let me see that. Show her the poem. Gunner's Ground. Yes, I think this will work. I'll go to the longhouse right away. And we get a cutscene. How long have they been in there? They're just starting. This isn't going to work. Why is that? I was thinking you should go in there and stop them before Gudrun makes a fool of herself. Don't be silly. You're right, it's too late now. We'll just have to see how it turns out. I can't hear what's happening. Can you hear what's happening? Gunther is laughing at something. He's probably considering the various tortures he has planned for me. Now you're just being ridiculous. The poem says you can honor your ancestors by settling peacefully on the land that they conquered. He's probably just finding it insulting. Now's your chance to find out. I hope at least they give me a decent burial. Freeman, Freeman, I have an announcement. I hear the chieftain speak. Hear the chieftain speak. Hear him, Kessel. We have always borne the legacy of our ancestors, and we have borne it with honor, says Gunthor. Shell for Gunner. From Gunthor. And though we honor them still, the time of our ancestors has passed. This is the time of Gunthor. For Gunthor, shouts Hakon. Gunthor says, this is Gunner's ground, bought with blood. Let it remain Gunner's ground forever. Here we settle. Gunner's ground, says Hakon. That was brilliant. I must know who wrote that poem, says Gudrun. Drorin replies, that would be me, hello. That line about beauty was for me, wasn't it, says Gudrun. Yes. You're the mystery poet who sent me the gold ring, says Gudrun. Sorry, he says. I had no idea dwarves could be so romantic. Come here, she says. Was so impressed by Doran's poem, he's made him the village poet. I'm more than a little surprised he even gave me a house to live in. Our people's tradition is that the tribe provides lodging for the poet. It's huge, says Doran. It's not in the village, it's easy here across the river and north of the road on the way to Varric. It's a big house with roses outside. I think Gunther wants to keep me close, but not too close. Oh, I found something there for you. Whoever lived there before left a dozen pairs of boots in the attic. I picked out a pair for you to thank you for all your help. Underneath them all was this magic lamp. You should have it as well. We're going to the new house. You should come and visit, says Gudrun. Yes, we'll see you there. I'll see you soon, I reply. Goodbye, says Gudrun. Goodbye, says Gudrun. Congratulations, quest is complete. You are awarded 5 quest points, 300 crafting XP, an antique lamp, swanky boots. I can talk to Dorn for more crafting tasks. I get 2 treasure hunt keys. I have a total of 24 quest points. Gunner's ground is completed. Examine the swanky boots. These swanky boots. Are obtained after completing the quest Gunner's Ground. According to Doran, the house he and Gudrun move in to after the quest, which before an update belonged to Juliet, contained dozens of pairs of these boots. As the destroy interface warns, the number of times you can reobtain these boots for free is limited. Players can talk to Doran in the house west of Varric to obtain another pair. After receiving the 12th pair, the initial pair upon completion of the quest, plus 11 subsequent claims, players will be asked to exchange a ruby ring for another pair. The boots can be stored in the costume box, fancy dress box in the costume room of your player-owned house. Players may only have one pair at any given time, including within a costume box. Additionally, these boots will not appear under your gravestone. Examine text references the BG song Staying Alive. Previously using exact lyrics from the song Well, you can tell by the way I use my walk, I'm a woman's man, no time to talk. It has since been changed to, you can tell by the way I use my walk, I'm too busy for a natter. Although you cannot use alchemy on the boots, according to the items kept on Death's interface, this item's value is 1,365 coins, the same as a ruby ring, which is used to get a pair after the 12th pair of boots. If the player loses membership while the boots are stored inside the POH, they cannot reclaim it in free-to-play. The boots give a small bonus to the magic stat before the evolution of combat. Okay. So. Okay, after the quest, you can go to what used to be Juliet's house near the cooking guild, and Dorian is now living there with Gudrun. You can talk to Corian and ask for additional tasks to engrave jewelry for him and receive up to 32,000 experience in crafting. If you talk to Corian after this quest, he will ask you to help in carving words on a ruby bracelet engraved with beauty blessed on it, dragonstone necklace engraved Gudrun on it, and onyx amulet engraved the most beautiful girl in the room on it. If you agree to help, you get an additional total of 32,000 experience. Free players can engrave the jewelry even though they can only be obtained by members. Temporary boost work. Okay, so. Basically, I've got to up my crafting, which right now is at 32. So I can't even upgrade those. Ruby bracelet requires a level 42, but I'm not going to deal with that right now. I am actually going to do this. I am going to go back up to Varric, I guess. Actually, I'm just going to, where am I at? I am. I'm going to go back up to Edgeville. If I remember, there's a bank there. And I will. Always go back to, there's a bank I can go to right there. And I shall put the boots inside. Interesting. There we go. And I'll rub the antique lamp and use it for the crafting. And I get 200 XP in crafting, yay. And I think I am going to roam around for a little bit, see what other little bits of mischief I can get into. Let's see what other quests I can do. I think I'm gonna try the one piercing note. One piercing note. Medium long.
Says as a continuing legend continues to the legend described in the story of the song from before the war. Let's see what that song before the war was. Okay, I'm not even gonna read that. Well, what? When I first saw Elspeth, I was at the edge of my village looking out over the front. Two distant lines of fire stood out against the evening landscape like smoldering coals thrown across a dark blanket. Sparks would shoot across the gap between the lines, burning arrows or war mages' spells. I couldn't see individual soldiers, but sometimes it's rather lengthy, and I really don't feel like reading all that. It can be read at the official Jagex site if anybody's interested in reading it from the RuneScape website. So we'll just do this. So where we need to go is the official description is there has been a murder in the Abbey of St. Elspeth, and the Abbess wants an adventurer to investigate. Can you find the mysterious killer without disturbing the sisters' lives of prayer and sacred music? We have to go to Al-Qarid. So let's see. I believe I have a lodestone set to there. Let's clear the marker. Where is that? There's the lodestone. Yes. And away we go. Go to the Abbey. Okay, so this is where we need to go to start.
Hey, are you going to the Abbey?
Type yes. Hold on here. Say yes.
Well, if you're heading to the Abbey, you should keep your ears open. Their music is famous all over the world. I can hear them sometimes, when the wind is right. Times like that, I don't mind I'm not catching any strike worms.
One piercing note quest is fully voice acted and features live recorded music. We suggest that you turn your sound on in order to get the most out of it. Already on. As they enter the abbey, okay, I'm randomly running all over the place. Oops. Guess I gotta go back. Find out where this sister is. Let's go back out here real quick. Sister Katarina. Thanks, Sar.
Thanks, Saradomin. You must be the adventurer the Abbess prayed for.
What do you mean?
Our Abbess prayed for an adventurer to come and help us. She asked me to stand here and wait for you to arrive. Will you help us, adventurer?
I need to know more before I decide.
I don't know anymore. Abbess Benita just said she was praying for an adventurer and told me to wait outside to meet you when you arrived.
Weren't you curious about why the Abbess had you wait here?
Well, I mean a bit, but we're not meant to question the Abbess's decisions.
Has anything unusual happened in the abbey lately?
Well, one of the older sisters died yesterday. Saradomin, guide her soul to light. The abbess says she went peacefully in her sleep. It's a bit odd that no one's been allowed to see her body, but it's not my place to question. Oh, another thing that's happened. A troubadour showed up earlier today. Abbess Benita didn't let him come inside, so he's camping here. We don't often get visitors, so that's a little odd.
Okay, yeah, I'll help. What the hell?
Saradomin be praised! The abbess's office is just inside the wall. Go in through the gate and head north.
She took my hand and danced with me. We kept dancing once the music went away. Oh, she's dancing in the stillness.
But come on, come back here. We need to talk with Abbess Benita, so that means we need to go here, to this door. Abbess Benita. Talk with Abbess Benita.
Adventurer, thanks Saradomin you've come.
What can I do to help? I'm not going to mess with her.
I've called you here for a sensitive task. One that I would prefer to deal with quietly, without involving the church authorities or the Al-Qarid Guard. I hope I can trust you to be discreet.
Of course.
One of our sisters has been murdered. Murdered quite brutally. I would like you to investigate. The killer may still be in the Abbey. I last saw Sister Anna at Vespers yesterday. When she wasn't present at Compline, I went to her cell and found her body. The murder must have taken place between those times.
And she gives me a key.
This is the key to Sister Anna's cell, where I found her body. The cells are in the southeast corner of the Abbey. I moved Sister Anna's body to the infirmary in the southwest of the Abbey. I cleaned and wrapped it myself, and I've forbidden the other sisters from seeing it. You should also question the sisters around the Abbey, but please do so subtly. I don't want them to know there has been a murder. This notebook will help you keep track of your investigation.
And I get a notebook. Yippee.
Come back to me when you've examined the crime scene and the body, and spoken to the sisters.
Key to the cell, investigator's notebook. Okay, so... let's go to the cell's southeast corner of the Abbey. That'd be here. In we go. Inspect the body. The body has been cleansed and put on burial robes. Any clues that were on the clothing have been lost. Victim's face has been horribly mutilated. The front of the skull has been bludgeoned in, and the skin of the face has been removed. On the back of the head, you find a blunt force wound as if she was hit by a heavy object. There is a row of three deep stab wounds at the victim's chest, one of them piercing her heart. The victim's feet have been heavily mutilated. Several toes have been cut off. Okay. Inspect bed here. Find anything interesting? Let's try this one here. Oh, I'm in the infirmary. Okay. Nothing there. Search the shelves. Let's go back out to the hallway, shall we? Here. Where's the bed at? I'm in an office.
Oh, I need to go all the way over here. So, let's go. So what we're doing right now is trying all the rooms. Ah, there we go. So let's search the bed. See what we find on the bed. We find a fragment of cloth under the bed. It looks like it's being torn from a larger piece of clothing. The material doesn't match the Sith Red Sister's habits. Okay. Let's see, what else can we find? Inspect the window, shall we? The window is broken, but there's no broken glass inside the cell. It looks like it's been broken from the inside. Let's check out. Over here. No. And let's go over to here. To the northwest side. Let's inspect the bed there. Nothing there, but let's try this bed. You find a fragment of cloth under the bed. It looks like it's been torn from a larger piece of clothing. The material doesn't match the Citadel Sisters' habits. Okay. Okay, so let's take a look and see what we've got in the investigator's notebook right now. May the light of Sarah Dolman, blah, 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 blah. Time to question the subjects. So let's go question the subjects. First one we need, there's five around. So let's go speak with Sister Cecilia east of the ground floor. Guessing that would be over here. Stop, stop. Talk with Sister Elena.
What is it?
Where were you between the Vespers and Compline yesterday?
I was here in the kitchen. Why? Where should I have been? I went down to the cellar to get some supplies at one point, but the rest of the time I was here. Actually, I noticed something when I was down there. I think someone's been stealing food from the cellar. I bet it was Katerina. Novices have to be taught discipline. I've seen her sneaking an extra cup of wine at meal times. She's the one you should be talking to.
What do you know about the troubadour outside?
I don't know anything about the troubadour. I didn't even know he was there. What troubadour? Secular music is forbidden. So if there is a troubadour outside, then Abbess Benita will send him away. I don't have time to talk about troubadours. Is there anything else you need? She's with Sarah Domin now. It doesn't matter what I thought of her, and it does no good to speak ill of the dead. I didn't say that, but she did cause conflict. Most of the sisters didn't see it, but I did. She was always arguing with the Abbess.
Arguing about what?
Sister Anna thought Sister Benita was too lenient with the Order's rules. Anna would have enforced silence outside of services. She'd have stopped Sister Cecilia composing, prescribed melodies only. Maybe it's Sarah Domin's will that Sister Anna never got to become Abbess. I don't know. It's not my place to say.
Goodbye. So let's go over here.
Look at me! Look at me!
This is Sister Cecilia.
Okay, that's good. Remember to look at me so you can keep in time. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't... Ladies, keep rehearsing while I talk to this pilgrim.
Where were you between Vespers and Compline yesterday?
Well, I stayed in here after Vespers to rehearse the choir.
What did you think of Sister Anna?
She had a powerful voice and a rock-solid sense of rhythm. The whole congregation could listen to her to keep in time. Oh, I'm sorry, she's dead. All I can think of is how much the choir needed her. I'm too single-minded sometimes. I think she kept us in time in more ways than one, though. She was our moral center, an example of holiness. We all miss her terribly.
What do you know about the troubadour outside?
I'm aware he's there. I think the abbess was right to forbid him from coming inside. You've got to understand, the Cithareid Order considers music to be holy. It should be used for worship and contemplation, not for dancing. Dancing is so often connected with other immorality. As interesting as it would be to hear a different style of music, I should stay away.
What are you rehearsing?
It's a hymn to Saint Elspeth. I wrote the music, but the words are traditional. Do you know the story of St. Elspeth and the Ripper?
No, could you tell me?
St. Elspeth was a holy warrior who lived during the God Wars. She sang and played the cithara, and her music was so holy that no demon could bear to hear it.
What's a cithara?
Oh, it's an ancient stringed instrument. It's like a lyre. The lyre was a folk instrument, whereas the cithara was a professional instrument. Well, anyway, that's not important. The Ripper was an assassin demon. It would strike without warning and leave its victims horribly mutilated, stab them through the heart with terrible claws, tear off their faces. Zamorak sent the Ripper to attack a village where St. Elspeth was staying. It couldn't approach while she was singing, but it waited on the edge of the village. She sang for days, but eventually was too weak to go on. She went out of the village to face the demon alone. She thought it might just kill her and spare the villagers. She fought the demon, and it mortally wounded her. But as she was dying, Saradomin granted her the strength to sing one piercing note so perfect that it struck the demon dead. Her remains lay unburied until the present age. Then, 70 years ago, a group of holy women found them and built this abbey in her memory. That's why music is such an important part of our worship.
Could the Ripper demon come back?
I don't know. They say some demons can return after being killed, but the God Wars were thousands of years ago.
Can your music repel demons?
Well, I'd like to think so, but I don't think we're as holy as St. Elspeth. I hope we never have to find out.
Back to my other questions. Okay, we're done with that one. Goodbye. Let me double check things here. Well, we know that the thing was a Ripper. Okay, so what else do we need to find out? Okay, let's go talk with Sister Catherine. She would be here.
Hello again, adventurer. How can I help?
What did you think of Sister Anna?
She was so holy. She thought about Saradomin all the time, never about herself. I don't know if I'll ever be as holy as that. She interviewed me when I applied to join the Abbey. It was like she could see right into my heart. To be honest, at first, she frightened me. I'm not surprised the other applicant left after she met her.
What other applicant?
Oh, another applicant came to the Abbey the other day. Her name was Isabella. She disappeared yesterday noon. She probably went home. A lot of applicants realize the life isn't for them and leave. Adventurer, if I can ask, why are you asking these questions?
I can't tell you, sorry.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have asked. I'll never be a full sister if I keep asking questions like that. Sister Anna always told me I shouldn't ask questions. Is there anything else I can do for you, adventurer?
What do you know about the troubadour outside?
It's so exciting that he's come to visit us. I saw him smiling at me when I was outside waiting for you. I kind of wish I could go out and dance. I used to like dancing, but I'm in the order now, and dancing isn't allowed.
Where were you between Vespers and the Compline yesterday?
I was in the scriptorium, copying a manuscript. I'm still learning how to illuminate the text. I've copied nearly the whole of the Book of Saradomin. I'm quite proud of it. Perhaps you'd like to see it after the funeral service, if you're still here. All right. I'll have to check if that's allowed, though. Come back and speak to me after the funeral.
Okay, goodbye. Okay, so let's go back to the kitchen.
What is it?
What are you cooking?
Cabbage soup. It's amazing what you can do with cabbages if they're all you have to cook with. Do you have an important question, adventurer? I'm quite busy.
Goodbye. Climb up the stairs.
Sister Katerina, is that you?
No, I'm an adventurer.
It's no good, Katerina. I can't hear you. I'll be out of here in a minute. Just need to get the, Could you do me a favor, Katerina? The clock is 20 minutes past right now. Could you set it to the right time? Do me a favor, Katerina. The clock is 20 minutes past right now. Could you set it to the right time? Ah, yes, that's it. Ah, you set the clock to the hour, so any moment now it should... Right, I'm done. Oh, I'm terribly sorry. I thought you were Sister Katerina. She's normally the one who comes up here. What can I do for you?
What did you think of Sister Anna?
A pot breaks that you'd expect it to hold for years, but that doesn't stop the whole mechanism. It just sets it in a different direction. Saradomin is a better clockmaker than us.
What do you mean?
Sister Benita was planning to retire as abbess next year. Everyone expected Sister Anna to become the new abbess. But it seems that wasn't Saradomin's plan, so he's taken her away. The clock runs, just not as we'd expected.
What do you know about the troubadour outside?
There's a minotaur outside? Have we closed the gates?
Not a minotaur, a troubadour.
Oh, yes. Sister Katerina mentioned something about that. She seemed very excited. I'm too busy with the clock to worry about visitors. It's not like I could hear his music anyway. I don't know if you'd noticed, but I'm a bit deaf. It's spending all my time close to the bell when it goes off that did that.
Where were you between Vespers and the Compline yesterday?
Between what and what?
Between Vespers and Compline.
Oh, I came back up here, tried to finish this set of repairs. I was a clockmaker before I joined the Abbey. Now I'm the only one who knows how to repair the Abbey clock.
Okay, goodbye. So we now get to go back downstairs. If I can find the damn stairs. Don't want to climb upstairs, want to go downstairs. There we go. There's the stairs we want. Okay, yes, I have to do one other thing. Go speak with the troubadour. We go out here. So we are going to go over here. We get to speak with.
I can see her dancing barefoot, there are flowers in her hair. I remember like I saw it yesterday. The sound of flutes and drums, she took my hand and danced with me. We kept dancing once the music went away. Oh, she's dancing in the stillness to the beat of bouncing drums. And she's dancing in the city and the crowd. And she's dancing on the mountain. And
greetings, traveler.
What were you singing about?
It's a song about someone I knew a long time ago.
You were singing about Sister Anna, weren't you?
I was. I knew her before she joined the Abbey. I tried to talk her out of coming here, but when she made her mind up about something, there was nothing that could stop her.
What are you doing at the Abbey?
One of the sisters here, Sister Anna, she passed away recently. I knew her before she joined the Abbey, so I've come to pay my respects.
How did you hear about her death?
I have my ear to the ground. Even a religious order isn't completely cut off from the world.
Where were you between Vespers and the Compline yesterday?
All yesterday evening I was in Al-Qarid. I didn't travel up here until this morning. Why are you asking all this anyway? What's going on here?
I can't tell you, sorry.
Oh, to Zamorak with you. The Abbess can order her sisters not to be curious, but not me. Anna was my friend, and I have a right to know what's happening. This conversation is over. Greetings, traveler. It's a song. I was. I knew her before she. One of the sisters here, Sister Anna, she passed. I have my ear to the ground. Even a religious order isn't completely cut off from the world. All yesterday evening I was in Al-Qarid. I didn't travel up here until this morning. One of the sisters here, Sister Anna, she passed away recently. I knew her before she joined the Abbey, so I've come to pay my respect.
Okay, so it looks like I had it all done. Wait a minute. Okay, so we go back to the Abbess. And away we go.
Please help us, adventurer. You'll need to examine Sister Anna's body, search her cell, and question the sisters in the Abbey. Whom do you suspect? Did you hear that? Quick! Follow the sound of that scream!
Okay, so we need to go. We need to go to the cellar, which is, I guess, through the kitchen. Oh, come on. Let's try through the kitchen. Oh, come on! Stop that crap. it's locked. Can I use the key? Nothing interesting happened, so we have to go to the chapel. Come on, how do I get here? Screaming women all over the place. Cellar through here. Climb down the stairs.
You've got to protect us. The demon is back.
What's happening here?
Oh, great Sarah Domin, Sister Eleanor. I saw it, Abbess. It was the demon. It was the Ripper.
Sister Cecilia, go back to the oratory. Get yourself cleaned up. Adventurer, there's no point in my trying to keep this from the sisters anymore. I'll let them know what's happening. Please, Adventurer, investigate Sister Eleanor's murder, then talk to me in my study.
Okay, so we get to investigate the body. The cuts on the body's arms and hands and several bloody stabs wounds in her torso. It looks as if she struggled and the killer stabbed her several times before finally hitting her heart. Her face is intact with none of the facial mutilations you found on the first body. The feet has several deep scratch marks, but are not as heavily mutilated as those of the first body. On the back of the head, you find a blunt force wound, as if she was hit by a heavy object. It was a glancing blow, as if the killer had attempted to knock the victim out, but missed. So now I get to search. Bloodstains. The stains are a mix of blood and red wine. It looks like the victim was carrying a barrel of wine when she was attacked. The arrangement of the stains suggests that the victim was murdered close to the reliquary and the body moved to its present position after death. Let's do something here. Let's brighten up things here a little bit. Settings. Okay. Thank you. Some of the robes are off the hooks and crumpled at the bottom of the cabinet, and others are pushed aside as if someone was hiding in the cabinet recently. Lighting detail, let's set it to medium. See what happens there. Okay, Mike, there we go. Oh, shoot, what just happened? Did I just get booted? Why, yes, I did. Well, that's easy enough to fix. Provided, of course. There we go. Where in the world am I? Okay, clues added, yeah. Well, as soon as it lets me in, I need to ask the woman for her cell key. And as soon as it lets me, I will ask the question I need. Talk to Abbess and Benita. Come on.
Adventurer, thanks Saradomin you're still here. Please tell me you're making some progress.
I need the key to Sister Elena's cell. And she gives me a key. Sister Elena's cell is located where? Well, we shall find out. Cancel that. We'll go to the next one. Let's see, maybe it's this one. Well, we shall find out. Nope. Let's try the key on this one. There we go. Search the footlocker. Don't find anything. How about the bed? find a bundle of letters under the bed. Okay. Read letters. The bundle contains a series of increasingly steamy love letters addressed to Sister Elena. The most recent is dated the day before Sister Anna's death and says that Elena's lover will visit that night. Several of the letters mention a secret passage in the kitchen that Sister Elena used to smuggle her lover from the abbey into the abbey. The letters are signed Valerio. And we go back to talk. And we go back to talk to the abbess again.
Adventurer, thanks Saradomin, you're still here. Please tell me you're making some progress.
I want to ask you about something I found. First of all, do you recognize this cloth fragment?
It's not from any of our robes. It looks like it's from some traveling clothes.
Tell me about the applicant who was here yesterday.
Her name was Isabella. She was here for a few days. Sister Anna and I both interviewed her. She wasn't allowed to mix much with the other sisters. She stayed in the applicant dormitory, which is directly to the west of this room. It's not unusual for a woman to decide that this life isn't for her. We don't pass judgment if someone doesn't say goodbye.
Is it true you argued with Sister Anna?
I wouldn't say we argued. We disagreed about certain theological issues. We had many invigorating discussions that I suppose an eavesdropper could mistake for arguments.
Did you know Sister Elena was seeing Valerio?
Oh, I thought that was over. A few months ago, Sister Anna brought me a stack of letters she'd found in Sister Eleanor's room. She was furious. Sister Anna wanted to expel Sister Eleanor, but I decided to give her a second chance. She appeared contrite. As long as she stopped seeing Valerio, I said she could stay in the abbey. It looks like Sister Anna was right. If Sister Eleanor were still alive, I suppose I would have to expel her. As it is, the other sisters don't need to know.
Okay, we go back. And what do? Let's go back into the, well, let's see if it's...
Adventurer, thanks Saradomin, you're still here. Please...
Let's see what we've got here if I go finish the investigation for now.
You're doing a good job, but I have a feeling there's some information you haven't found yet.
Okay, so we'll go into the kitchen. God damn it. I hate when this shit happens. Open the door, and then we go to the kitchen. Search the sacks. The sacks are stacked to hide a hole in the bottom of the wall, large enough for a person to squeeze through. Looks like the sacks have been disturbed recently. Okay, now we can go and talk again with Music Dude. Heading over to speak with the music guy. Speak with him again.
Greetings, traveler.
Were you having an affair with Sister Elena?
I don't know what you're talking about. Why are you asking this?
I found letters from you in Sister Elena's cell.
I didn't write any letters. They must be from someone else.
Sister Elena is dead.
Elena is dead?
Yes.
Elena. She wasn't happy here, you know. She could have been so much more if she had the courage to leave. I met her when she came down to Al-Qarid to buy supplies. We started writing to one another, hiding letters with boxes of food. I came up to see her last night. There was a hole in the kitchen wall that she used to smuggle me in. That's how I learned that Anna had died. Elena told me. I wanted to publicly pay my respects, so I snuck back to Al-Qarid and came here with my band. Adventurer, you don't think Elena could have been killed because of me? Both the victims were people I knew. Could someone have found the letters and... If there's anything I can do to help bring this killer to justice, let me know.
I think you killed Anna and Elena, just for the
I
record.
I loved Elena. How dare you accuse me? Come back when you have some kind of evidence.
Talk to Sister Katarina.
Dance with me, adventurer.
I thought your order forbade dancing.
It's all right. I'm just a novice. I haven't taken vows. I'm not allowed. Anyway, I think I might leave the order. I haven't decided yet. With what's happening, it makes me think about how I want to spend my life. And I love Saradomin, and I love the order, but I don't think I want to spend my whole life not dancing. Come on, adventurer. Dance with me for a while. All right. See you later, adventurer. Dance with me, adventurer. There's no need to be like that. I'm just dancing.
See if I'm missing anything. I wonder if I have to go into that room again.
going to die. It's going to kill us all. There's no escape.
Can you tell me exactly what happened?
I heard the scream. I heard Sister Eleanor screaming. So I went down the stairs to see and... And it was there! The river! Just like in the stories. It was wrapped in rags and it had its huge claws and... It was bending over Sister Eleanor. It was cutting her feet with its claws. Why would it do that? Then it saw me. It turned its head. It looked at me. I couldn't see its face, thanks, Saradomin. If I'd seen its face, I think I might have died of fright. It pushed past me. It splashed Sister Elena's blood onto my robes. And then it ran up the stairs and away. We can't let it defeat us. Almighty Saradomin, give me the strength to not be afraid.
Okay, what am I missing here?
All right, ladies. The abbess told you what happened. This funeral service will be for two of us now. We're going to trust Saradomin, and we're not going to be afraid. We're going to sing like Saint Elspeth, and the demon isn't going to be able to hurt us. Okay, from the top, look at me.
And now we go back down to the abyss.
Adventurer, thank Saradomin you're still here.
You did know about the secret passages in the kitchen.
A secret passage? That could be how the killer got away after murdering Sister Eleanor. Thank you, adventurer. I'll have the passage blocked immediately. Adventurer, thanks Saradomin you're still here.
Yeah, whatever.
Whom do you suspect?
Whom do I suspect?
I suppose it's possible. I want to be absolutely sure before we move, though. Whoever the killer is, I'm worried that they'll strike again. I want to make sure that all the sisters are safe in the Abbey. Sister Katerina is outside dancing. I don't want to pass judgment on her, not now. But I think she'd be safer inside. Could you go and fetch her, please?
Sure. I'll go get her.
With me, adventurer.
Abbess Benita asked me to bring you back to the Abbey.
All right. I should finish copying my book of Saradomin. I'll be in the scriptorium if you want to talk to me.
Okay, I don't know what we've got a cutscene here, but Catherine is dead, it looks like. Okay, so I gotta go unlock the stupid thing. Operate the winch. Climb down the ladder. Come on. Investigate the body.
It's no good. She's dead. Good night, sweet thing. You could have been a dancer.
What was that sound? Adventurer? Oh, merciful Saradomin. Sister Katarina, is she...
I'm afraid so.
This must end. Adventurer, troubadour, please meet me in my office. We need a plan.
Investigate the body. You've been down to examine the still warm body of Sister Katarina. There are stab wounds through the chest. One of them pierces the heart. They match the wounds on the first and second bodies. The face is intact with none of the facial mutilations you found on the first body. The victim's feet have shallow scratches as if the killer wanted to mutilate them but didn't have time to do a thorough job. Alright, back into the old woman's place. Talk with the Abbess.
The killer is going to strike again, unless we catch them.
I'm not a member of your order, Abbess. I don't know why you would trust me here.
All the sisters of my order are suspects. The two of you are the only people I have seen in the same place as the killer. So you are the only people I can trust. I will not let this defeat us. We must arrive at a plan. Adventurer, after all you've seen, whom do you now suspect?
Ripper demon back from the dead.
Then we must pray for Saradomin to be with us.
A demon? Then what hope do we have?
None of us is Saint Elspeth, but if Saradomin is with us, we will prevail. How do you propose to fight it, adventurer?
let's see. After the conference pick up again, let's see. It's this bit. Suggest a new target target as bait. We should lay a trap.
That could work. But how would we bait it?
A new victim?
That could tempt the killer out, but who? I don't think the killer is indiscriminate. What do the victims so far have in common?
Easy. They were all associated with Valerio.
I know about your involvement with Sister Elena, and perhaps the killer could have seen Sister Katerina dancing and thought that. But what about Sister Anna? She hadn't left the Abbey for years.
Ah, you do not know. I knew Anna many years ago. She was a dancing girl, part of the troupe that I joined when I was first a troubadour. Back then she was so full of life, passionate. Everything she did, she threw her whole body and soul into it. Then, when we met that traveling preacher and she caught religion, she threw her whole body and soul into that as well. We wrote to one another at first and...
She never mentioned you to me. All she would say was that her past life was sinful and she wanted to put it behind her.
Yes, that was the impression I got from her last letters. When I met Elena in Alcarid and started seeing her, we had to keep our affair secret. So I couldn't see Anna. I wanted to. A part of me was always hoping she'd discover us.
Enough! We don't need to go through the sordid details. We've established a connection. But how does it help us?
I have a dancing girl traveling with me. If we were to announce that she was joining the Abbey...
I can't allow her to be put in danger. There must be another way.
She will be in no danger. She will be hiding in my camp. We can make a dummy, dress it in your robes, and our adventurer can hide nearby and wait. But I'm not sure where.
In the basement. During the funeral service, all the sisters will be in the oratory. It will be the perfect time for the killer to strike. It seems we have a plan. Valerio, you and I can handle the announcement. Adventurer, you will need to make the dummy in the basement. Once you're ready, you can hide in the robe cabinet and wait. Whether this killer be demon or mortal, I swear they will not kill again. Saradomin, go with all of us.
Okay, so let's go down to the cabbage patch first. Grab a cabbage. Pick another one just to be on the safe side. And let's go back down to the this, we gotta move the candelabra next to the reliquary. Cabbage. The candelabrum. Okay. And now we have to go back to the cabinet. It's right here. Take a citrate clothes. All of that stuff is there. And we need to go hide in the cabinet that we just came from. Hide in robe cabinet. The robe cabinet looks like the perfect place to hide and wait for the skiller to strike. So, hide in the cabinet and wait. Cutscene. Yeah, my computer sucks. Okay, we got to go upstairs. Chase it around the freaking abbey. I can see her dancing barefoot, there are flowers in her hair. Come on. I hate my computer sometimes, folks. It's not letting me. There. Up the stairs we go. Climb up the stairs.
Oh,
talk to Sister Deborah.
Please help us, adventurer. But if you are destined to fail, may Sarah Doman help me accept my fate.
What in the hell does that mean? Come on, climb down the bloody stairs. Go out to there. See what happens. Wait a minute. I'm not getting any freaking cutscenes from any of this. Why is that? Pray at the altar, what the heck, while I'm here. Have full prayer points, yay. Heads to the kitchen. Okay, we've got that. Okay, so let's go out here. Okay, back inside we go. Come on. Jesus Mary. I gotta go back down to the freaking basement.
Barefoot, there are flowers in her hair.
Oh, come on. I have to do this all over again. That's gonna suck. Nope. Oh, what's over here? Back up the stairs. Now she is talking to a preacher. He says dancing is a sin. And now I'm looking at her feet and they don't move. And now we're standing at the Abbey and we're saying our goodbyes. But I know she'll be the one I always love. Alright guys, I am not going sure what the heck's going on, where I need to go right now from here. I'm supposed to be chasing this guy, but I don't see him anywhere. So, I am going to examine the belt. Its ringing would be deafening, yes, yes, yes. Of that one, I'm sure. Let's climb back downstairs. How in the hell did I do that? Time to climb back up the damn stairs. This is really starting to irritate me, folks. There. come on. Come on. Climb up the stairs. Maybe I can go all the way up. Get up there. Just catch you this time. Oh, come on. Where am I at? Come on. Climb the stairs, see what happens.
Stay back!
Ah,
make
there we
any
go.
Move and I'll kill her!
Let her go, is what I'm saying.
Let me walk out of the abbey to safety, and then I'll release her.
Yeah, fat chance on that.
Adventurer! Don't!
You won't kill her, I see.
I don't want to kill her, but you'll force me to if you come closer. Her death will be on your hands.
I need to get this thing around so I can see what the heck I'm doing here. There. Who are you? Let's find out.
I am the spirit of St. Elspeth, Sarah Domin's voice of justice.
You don't say
Sister it. Anna! She's gone mad!
You're dead.
Sister Anna is dead!
I am the spirit of St. Elspeth.
She killed the applicant and dressed her in her robes.
Why did you kill all those people?
They were all dancers! They weren't worthy to be in this abbey. St. Elspeth commanded me to remove them.
You were a dancer too, once.
I was repentant! That's the difference! I spent my whole life in penitence for the sins of my youth. And now Abbess Benita lets any dancing girl join the abbey. Lets them go outside and dance when a troubadour arrives. Turns a blind eye to their affairs.
You were jealous of Elena and Valerio.
He means nothing to me. That part of my life is gone.
You were a dancer too once.
I was repentant.
Okay, yeah. Okay, you got that part. Let's go back.
Spawn of Zamorak! Demons and saints look the same to those whose eyes are blinded by evil.
You're possibly possessed by the demon. Fight it.
No! It is St. Elspeth! Get away from me, tempter of Zamorak! mind has never been so clear. I burn with the holy fire of Saradomin.
Back. Can you hear the singing?
I can hear it. The choir.
They all loved you, the sisters and Valerio.
They all loved me. No! Worldly attachments, worldly love must all be burned away! I am the spirit of Saint Elspeth.
That's your funeral time for you
Stay
to
back.
Die.
Make any move and I'll kill her!
Enough talk. Let's see, what should I need to do? Okay, I guess I have to go back downstairs.
Crap.
Go back downstairs, operate the clock mechanism. What the hell am I doing all the way back? Goddamn. Back upstairs. Come on. Climb upstairs. Nope. Go back up the stairs one more time. Oh, come on. Go over here to the clock mechanism thingy. Operate clock mechanism. So I get to play with the clock again to make sure it gets to noon. You hear the clock mechanism catch, the bell will ring in a few moments. So I get to go back up the stairs.
Stay back! Make any move and I'll kill her!
Why did you kill all those people?
They were all dancers! They weren't worthy to be in this abbey. Saint Elspeth commanded me to remove them.
You were a dancer too once.
I was repentant! I spent my whole whole life in penitence for the sins of my...
Listen, is that the bell ringing? Okay, now what? Return and talk to Sister Anne again. Sister Deborah pulls off Sister Anna's claws, sorting over the tower. Talk to Sister Deborah and she will leave. Talk to Sister Deborah.
Good thinking, adventurer.
Are you all right?
I'm just shaken. I don't normally get that much excitement.
You move pretty quickly.
Perhaps Saradomin gave me strength.
What should we do with Sister Anna?
As a good Saradominist sister, I cannot take a life. I'll see you downstairs, adventurer.
Okay. Talk to Sister Anna.
Sister Deborah. She did nothing wrong. I have not been the voice of Saint Elspeth. I have been the hand of the Ripper.
All right.
Please, adventurer, if you have any mercy, give me a moment to pray for forgiveness before I die.
Sure, I'll give you that.
Almighty Saradomin, creator and ruler of the world, have mercy upon me, for I have sinned against thee with my thoughts, with my voice, and with my hands. As the voice of Saint Elspeth struck dead the demon, may it strike dead the evil in my heart. And may the harmony of the saints drown out the discord of my sin. Hear it. The Holy Choir. I am forgiven. Flights of Icene lift me up. Saradomin, guide my soul to light.
Okay, what the hell is she? Oh shit, she's jumping. She goes bye bye. Looks like she is committing suicide. So we talk to the woman again.
Thank Saradomin, it's over, adventurer. Sister Deborah told me what you did, but she didn't say who the killer was. She said you should be the one to tell us.
Who was it? Who killed Anna and the others?
It was Sister Anna.
What?
No, it can't be.
She was quite mad. She murdered the applicant, dressed the body in her robes.
But why?
think she was possessed by a demon.
But my most trusted friend could do this, and I had no idea. Thank you for telling the truth, adventurer. But this will shake the faith of everyone in the Abbey. I can't remain as Abbess, knowing that this evil could sprout in soil that I have tended. I'll look for a replacement, but I don't know how much longer the Order will survive. I cannot offer you much of a reward, adventurer, but please accept a set of the Order's robes. They are enchanted. Wearing them will allow you to meditate on music in order to grow closer to Saradomin.
Okay, sure. Yay. You have completed one piercing note. You were awarded 2 quest points, a scissory rope set, 250 XP prayer XP lamp, troubadour dance emote, 2 treasure hunter keys. Total quest points is 26. Yay. Completed one piercing note. Let's see what my emotes are, just out of stupid curiosity. Raspberry clamp. What are these? These are jig. Dance. Yes, I am trying out my emotes, folks. Just for the crack of it. Raspberry, what is this? Salute. Clap. Oh, what's this? This is... Oh, safety first, never mind. Let's go to all chat, and I think I am going to... go back to Varen, and then I am going to camp out at the bank, because I think I am done for the night. It's already 3:37 in the morning here. That being said, I really do need to go get some sleep. Just waiting for this to do so, so I can do so. And let's bring this back, bring this back. I am in Varric, or whatever you call it. I'm gonna go camp out actually by... yeah, come on, let's get me over to the bank. Go to the bank. Deposit all this into the bank. Come on. what it is, what I'm going to do, ladies and gentlemen, I'm just going to go ahead and end the stream here. I hope you all enjoyed yourself. Thank you very much for visiting, and I hope you all have a great night.